What is up, everybody? Okay, so today we're going to be playing some World of Tanks. I'm deciding to do a little bit of a shorter video today because, oh lord, that might be a little bit of not that quite there. I'm deciding to do a bit of a shorter episode today because, got some spaghetti cooking over in the kitchen and I don't want that to mess up. So that's why I'm doing a World Tanks video. It should go very well. I decided while I'm playing the game, I'm going to talk about a very great movie that came out recently. I guess this might be a little bit of a movie review, I'm not sure. But, a great movie came out recently, called Rogue One, The Star Wars Story. Yeah. So I've already gone over the fact that it's great. I'd say from a scale of 1 to 10, it's probably about an 8. I do not care about end user license agreements. Let's just accept and move on. What is on the bulletin? Box received. Open subsequent boxes automatically. Let's open this box. New Year Bustle. Whatever. So, great movie. It is absolutely wonderful. Storytelling could have been worked on a little bit. I do not want to watch video right now. Let's just X out of that. A siege mode. Huh. I'll watch that. I'll check that out later. Huh. This is interesting. I'm sorry, guys. This is taking. Oh, look, Santa in a tank. That's. Oh, that's good. I've been needing an extra slot in the garage. Okay, that's pretty good. So, tree skirt, what? Oh, okay. Boom! Beautiful tree. Don't care. Close. Okay, so. What are these? Oh, they must have gotten a new, class of tanks in or something, I don't know. Wait a minute, what kind of, what country tank? I think this might be the German tanks, who knows? No, that's the German tanks. What? You know what, whatever. Which one did I just get? That's a tier one. Did I get this one? Yeah, I got this one. Service this. I want it about even. Okay, yes, this is. Oh, no, that is not it, Sam. Not it. Oh, okay, so I can only have AP. I got enough credits. Okay. I'm sorry it's taking me so long. I need to go ahead and get into it. I really need to go ahead and get into it. So let's get into it. Never played with this tank. This is the first time, so gonna see how it rolls. Back to Rogue One. It starts off, I don't know, I better not tell everything about it. But I will say this. it's sort of slow in the beginning, and it builds, like, it really builds up to a just absolutely wonderful time. And so they complete Death Star. That's Death Star 1. But so that's, and the center of the movie was, of course, getting the Death Star plans. So
let's go.
What ends up happening is that, oh, this tank's got this tank bougie. Oh shit! Pile up. Few tank pile up. Oh gosh, actually this is going badly for the enemy team. They sort of pushed up right into the center of the town. And so they're just flanked. They blow up this city in a desert. Things just go badly for the rebellion at first. They're not even really, in actuality, like sort of the quote unquote good guys in this movie. Oh well, Dagnab. Hi, buddy. Blown up. But so they go to Jedha, it all gets blown up. Okay. And then, let's do another battle. This one's really good. So that gets blown up. Turns out the Death Star actually has different levels of power. The destructive force, it goes anywhere from destroying a planet to destroying just an area on a planet. Yeah, I know, it sounds weird. But so, and it goes through the movie steadily. And, eventually it gets to a point where, it gets to a point where, there's one final stand on this, this tropical planet. It's really tropical, really beautiful. But, but so, really beautiful tropical planet. It's called Scarif. And that is where this, Imperial Information Cache is located. It holds all the information of the Empire, including the plans for the Death Star. Oh yeah, and you know the thing, you know, why does a small thing destroy this giant battle station? Well, we now know, it was actually a thing placed inside the, Death Star by its designer, because he was forced to build the Death Star. There was no willingness to all this. He was forced to construct this super weapon. So he decided to turn that good and make a super weakness in the weapon. And so, and so he ends up, so, and he hides this, this weakness, a really strong weakness. If any pressure is applied, not high, buddy. Any pressure is applied to the main reactor, the entire thing goes. Oh, that was so close! But yeah, so this flaw is now in the, this weakness. Is in Death Star. But they have to get the Death Star planned to figure out where that weakness is at exactly. So, oh, that was so great. But, so they go to Scarif, and actually, truly, the Rebellion was not wanting to go to Scarif. They were just like, we need to disband and just hide. Forget this, they have a super weapon that will destroy us all.
We didn't penetrate their armor.
What the?
We didn't even scratch them.
Hi, buddy!
Oh dear god, we're about to die. We're about to die. Well, let's go around the place of glory! That was terrible.
Everyone get out.
So, they have to get Death Star plans. So they go on Scarif, this small group that they have dubbed themselves Rogue One. Because they were asked by the Rebellion for a call sign when they were leaving. And they said, it's Rogue One. And they said, there is no Rogue One. And then the comedian, the entire group says, well, there is one now. And so they go to Scarif, and they, I'm sorry, I keep losing my train of thought here, guys. They attack. They come up with a decisive plan to start blowing stuff up to draw the Empire out. The Empire has no idea where they're at. And we just start shooting them up. Well, the Rebellion starts shooting them up. And then the rest of the Rebellion's like, well, they're already there. So, let's just go for it. Leroy Jenkins! But yeah, so they just go for it. Oh, dear lord. We ain't gonna capture this base. Nope, there's only one left now. But, so, but then the Death Troopers show up and the battle starts going sour for the Rebellion. But of course, then the rest of the Rebellion shows up. The entire Rebellion fleet. They just got everybody going, just like, we're gone! And so they flew in there. And they started laying waste to it. A few people flew into the planet below to provide air support. And it is just amazing. This compares to the Battle of Hoth, or the Battle of Endor. Like, that's how good it is. Shut up. But that is how good it all is. And so, everything happens. Jin, that's the main character. And Cassian, that's another main character. They get inside, along with K2, so that he can open things. He's an Imperial Enforcer droid, I believe. And they get in there, they get into the records and everything, and they find the Death Star plans, but then they can't get out. So they have to come up with this crazy way to climb up, get outside, and then turns out with the shield that's around the entire planet, they can't relay it without using the Empire's own satellite dish. So Jin has to plug in put in the Death Star plans. Somebody else has to take down the shield gate, which in turn takes down the shield, so that Jin can send off the Death Star plans, and then they get the Death Star plans up in the main Rebel flagship. But then, once the Rebellion has defeated most everybody, the Death Star shows up. The entire Death Star. It jumped into hyperdrive and popped right up in there. And the Rebellion fleet's like, oh no, we gotta get out of here. So they start jumping in hyperspace. Oh, good lord. May your beds. They start jumping into hyperspace and they're just running. But then, then a man on the Star Destroyer asks Tarkin, so, what about the Rebel fleet? And then Tarkin says, as always, Lord Vader will take care of the Rebel fleet. And the next thing you know, an Imperial Star Destroyer shows up, just guns blazing, and takes out loads of ships, disables the Rebel flagship, and then it happens. Darth Vader, he boards the Rebel flagship, and like, first you don't see it, they're in a dark hallway, and then it just seems like the darkness is just moving. It's like it's a solid thing. And there's only like one light at the end of the hallway. The next thing you know, the dark end of the hallway, Darth Vader's lightsaber ignites, and there is Darth Vader standing. The Rebel troops there in that hallway, they open fire, but there's just nothing they can do. Darth Vader's force choking people, throwing them up against the walls, the ceiling. He uses the force to take their blasters. He's hacking people apart, and the door that is jammed. So the man that has the Death Star plane is trying to, is holding it through the door, the crack in the door, hoping somebody will grab them. Somebody grabs them, and as they grab them, Darth Vader stabs the man that was holding out the plans. He walks in. After he slices open the door, walks in, man with the plans, running down the hallway, he trips, you're like, oh no, is Darth Vader gonna get him? And then he jumps into this door, they close the door, and then somebody pulls a lever, it drops the Tantive V out of the bottom of the Rebel flagship. The Tantive V is the ship that, the first ship you see at the beginning of episode 4, A New Hope. Drops out the bottom of the ship and just goes. And Darth Vader's walking out and he's just staring at it like, dagnabbit! And then the man with the plans, hands the plans to Princess Leia. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Hold on. Here we go. Oh, this is terrible. Never mind. Back up. Hold on a minute. I'm sorry, people. Just bear with me.
After five.
This is the wrong one. No, I don't want to go to Raft. Just bear with me, we're almost there!
After 5 seasons of Grimm,
I don't care about Grimm, I hate that show.
Has led to this. So it is a-
And yes, we have bought the server. So, all the way to the end. Hold on, credits. Okay. Here we go. And here's the end of episode 7 for all y'all that haven't seen. Rogue One. I loved the movie. It was absolutely wonderful. If you enjoyed this video, please like, subscribe, comment. Who cares? Do something. Thank you, and have a nice day. See you on Thursday.